Now, I also want you to understand that the ADHD drugs don't regulate the emotion of ADHD identically. They all do it effectively, but they do it through different pathways. And this can help you to understand the drug responses that your patients, your clients may be having. For instance, let's take the stimulants. The stimulants work in controlling emotion by suppressing the limbic system. The higher the dose you give, the less activity in that system. Okay, well, that's certainly one way to skin a cat, isn't it? I can control your affect by eliminating your affect. But remember, the limbic system was not impaired in ADHD. It's not part of the ADHD neuroanatomy. But one way to control emotion is to prevent it from occurring to begin with, and that's what the stimulants do. And now you know why 1 in 5 patients complains to you of emotional blunting, that the patient becomes like almost an automaton. They begin to lose their affect. Yes, they're compliant. Yes, they're productive. Yes, they're obedient. But that's all they are. Parents in particular are very concerned about this side effect and often stop their stimulant medication because they don't like what this child has become. They don't see the joie de vivre, the affection of the child. We want this kid to be poking his sister once in a while, to be getting a little upset. I don't need a bland robot that sits at a computer. And yet some of these kids can get that way. So we have to be careful with stimulants, because if you push the dose too high, you can get blunting of normal emotions, which really isn't the goal after all, is it? Now, let's take the non-stimulant, atomoxetine, for instance, the norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. That's Strattera. What does that do? It has no effect on the limbic system whatsoever, but it activates the anterior cingulate and the frontal lobe. It activates the executive that is managing the emotion. So what would I predict from that? That atomoxetine will be better at regulating the emotional symptoms of ADHD than the stimulants will be, because it's doing it at the site where the problem is, at the site of the executive system that isn't down-regulating affect to the extent that it should. You will also find that atomoxetine does not produce the side effect of emotional blunting. There's never been any complaints about that in any of the literature, to my knowledge. Now you know why we are seeing clinicians in this country combining these medications. And they're doing it to get greater coverage across this range of ADHD symptoms. The stimulants are really good at improving your attention and executive system, your cold cognition, your working memory. They're not so good at necessarily handling the emotional dysregulation. So by adding in a non-stimulant, you're able to keep both drugs at lower doses, that's always a good thing, and get wider coverage across the ADHD symptom complex, including emotional dysregulation. Now, what about the third drug that's on the market, that came on the market a couple years ago? Intuniv. Intuniv is guanfacine XR, extended release. Guanfacine has been around for years as an antihypertensive drug. It's used to treat high blood pressure. But it also has been known to have psychiatric, psychopharmacological properties. And it is beneficial to people with ADHD and Tourette syndrome. So Shire simply took and reformulated it so that the drug lasts longer. Now, what does guanfacine do? Well, guanfacine is an alpha-2 regulator. It goes to the frontal lobe, and it fine-tunes the signal in nerve cells. So unlike stimulants, which affect the expression of dopamine and norepinephrine, but mainly dopamine, and they do it usually through increasing production and blocking reuptake, guanfacine has its effect by latching on to a nerve fiber and opening or closing the little ports along the nerve cell, the alpha-2 ports. And if you close the alpha-2 port, the signal is stronger down the nerve cell. If you open the little alpha-2 port, the signal gets dampened and noise comes into the signal. What guanfacine does is to fine-tune frontal nerve cells so that signals are stronger, less confounded by noise, more likely to reach their endpoint and have an effect. So this would argue that, like atomoxetine, guanfacine might well be activating the executive system so that the signals from the executive system are cleaner, purer, stronger. Here again, you might use guanfacine like you use atomoxetine to address the emotional component of ADHD where stimulants might not be so good at doing that. And what are we seeing in the U.S. today? Clinicians combining Intuniv with a stimulant to do just that. Lower doses, much more pervasive coverage of ADHD symptoms. So by understanding how the drugs work in the brain, we have a better understanding of how they manage the emotional aspect of ADHD. By the way, 70% of the brain areas activated by the ADHD drugs are shared. So they have a lot in common, which is why they're ADHD drugs. But 30% of the effect of a drug is not shared with the other drugs. And it tends to be mainly in these emotion regulation centers that we see some of this non-overlap of drug response.